In this video, you'll be able to create parallax scroll animation in Figma in two simple steps. This effect offers a fantastic opportunity to breathe life and intrigue into your website designs. You can access the Figma file from the description below, so there's no reason to delay. Before we dive into the creation of this effect, let's take a moment to demystify the parallax effect for beginners. At its core, the parallax effect is all about adding depth and dynamism to your design. To achieve it, you'll need at least two objects in your design canvas. These objects can be text, images, blurs, shapes, or anything your creative art desires. What makes parallax captivating is the way you manipulate the positions of these objects as your user scrolls through your design. It's all about creating a delightful and somewhat unpredictable interplay between these elements. So, let's design. In this example, let's apply the effect to our planets. I have a bunch of planet illustrations, and to get that, I use the plugin Icons 8 that you can see here on top. So go to Plugins, Manage Plugins, and search for Icons 8, Icons, Illustrations and Photos. And after run, you can get these images or other ones. Remember that you can use the link to this file in the video description. Then I have here a text object that says planets. And if you take a closer look at our layers panel, I have this text layer on top of all images because I want to be always visible on top of all information. But if you want to mix it up, you can put it in the middle and see what happens. So let's create a new frame. That will be our default frame. And I'll create a gradient fill background. And for that, I will choose some dark blues that will represent the universe. Something like that. Then click T to select type tool and type planets. And position it somewhere here. Now to make it faster for you, I will just select, copy and paste the images from here to my default frame. Here you set the image's position and size. Play around, and when you think you're done, select the default frame and hit Command D to duplicate it into a new frame. And let's rename it to Motion Frame. You can also add a scroll bar for this example to have some hint for the user that he can scroll the page. So let's add here a rectangle and adjust the corner radius. And duplicate this and also put it in the bottom of our motion frame. Now you can start changing the position of elements here. So I'll put this planet here, this one somewhere here, and keep doing the adjustments in the other ones. Just a quick tip, if you want to move something outside the frame but you don't want that object to be out of the frame, so I will select this planet for that example, and then first hold down shift and hold down space, and I can move it outside without them actually being pushed outside of the frame, as you can see here in our layers panel. Okay, so now let's check if everything is like you want, and let's move to step 2, which is where we had the parallax interactions using drag and smart animate. So before that, let's change the height of both frames to 900 so that they are actually looking like desktop frames, and then select here in the right hand side the tab prototype and make the default frame as our flow starting point. Now mouse over the scroll bar here and drag on top of motion frame, and let's set the drag interaction here. And smart animate is out with 1000 milliseconds, and then do the same in the other scroll bar to have the opposite movement. Now let's hit play to run our prototype to test the animation. And there you go, here's a fun parallax effect that you can use to start your explorations or work to clients. I hope you enjoyed the video and learn in these two steps how to create parallax effect into your prototypes in Figma. If you learned something, please let me know in the comments, thumbs up this video, and if you're not yet subscribed, follow our channel. Thank you and have a great day.